Today, I want to share with you something that I read inside a hypnotherapist website. And this is great discussion material and a learning opportunity. So I'm going to read it. So, one in five people cannot harness the incredible power of their subconscious mind because they're difficult to hypnotize. This is coming from a hypnotherapist's website. And to me, this is really shocking. So, one in five cannot harness the power of their subconscious mind or unconscious mind. And first of all, that is incorrect. Let's dispel that myth right there. Each and every person in this world has an unconscious mind, and each and every person can harness that unconscious mind. And let's get to the very basic of the unconscious mind here, because what I'm hearing from a lot of coaches and hypnotherapists is that there's really not a lot of information or actual valuable information out there when it comes to the unconscious mind. We believe that the unconscious mind is this amorphous thing that we can harness that is outside of us. Truth of the matter is, we are an unconscious mind at play, right? If you think of the brain is within our skull, but the neurons from our brains travel from our spinal cord all the way to our peripheries, through our peripheral nervous system. And all of that is an unconscious process, right? We don't need to think about, if I press this part of my knuckle here in my right middle finger, I don't have to think about the fact that I can feel this finger on this finger, right? It's an unconscious process. I can feel the sensation. I can feel that my hands and my fingers are there. These are unconscious processes that I don't have to be like, okay, lift this, lift that. If I were to grab my watch here, I don't have to think about it. It's unconscious. That is what the unconscious mind is. Very, very simple, right? So it's not an amorphous thing that we have to harness, that we have to get somewhere from the ethers. That's not what it is. So let's dispel that myth right there. And so this is really problematic, because then what happens to, if we have 10 clients and it is one in five, if two can't harness the unconscious mind, what the hell do we do then? Are we going to say, I'm sorry, the two of you, I cannot help you? But that's actually false, because all of us can harness our unconscious information. We do this all the time. We are not always consciously aware of everything in our brains. We are not always conscious of our memories, right? If we think about the unconscious mind, we have learned that it stores our lifetime, right? The events, everything, our memories, our experiences, everything that we learned is stored unconsciously. It's stored in the unconscious part of our brains, in our memory bank, in our hippocampus, the movements we have. We don't have to learn every time how to walk and get out of bed. We do this unconsciously. We just retrieve that information whenever we need it. If I ask you a question, who was your fifth grade teacher that was your favorite? That is an unconscious information for you, right? You're not really consciously thinking about your favorite fifth grade teacher, whoever that was for you. You'd have to retrieve it unconsciously. But just because that is not currently in your conscious awareness, it doesn't mean it's there. You just have to go back to your own unconscious storage to retrieve it. And so we can access our unconscious mind, retrieving the information for the answer to who your favorite fifth grade teacher is how we retrieve unconscious information. It's how we retrieve the information from our conscious mind. It's how we retrieve and harness the power that is the process that we use naturally as humans. So I just wanted to talk about this because it's really interesting how this is not unfortunately common knowledge, and it can be very misleading. And so, going back to that statement of one in five cannot be hypnotized, how wherever that statement came from, what I'm really just trying to point out is the fact that it was incorrect that partly like one in five cannot harness their unconscious mind, but there may be truth to, one in five people cannot be forcefully hypnotized. Because when we think of the traditional hypnosis, it's all about relaxation. It's about, clucking like a chicken and being extremely suggestible and forgetting that you were clucking like a chicken, or pretending you were having the best orgasm in your life. That is that is not really what therapeutic hypnosis is. And it's true, maybe one in five cannot go into that hypnotic state, but it doesn't mean that that same person who cannot easily go into that hypnotic state cannot access their unconscious mind. They can, of course, because if they can't access their unconscious processes, they would not be alive, right? Our heart rate, our breathing are all unconscious processes. So when we think about it this really, really simply, and this is what we teach in our ACH trainings, being very simple, that is what the unconscious mind is, not an ethereal thing that we grab from somewhere. It is using what we have already as humans. And so when we start thinking about it this way, then our transformations get faster because we have a more thorough understanding of what is currently happening with ourselves right now. We are working with what we have, our body, our unconscious mind that is sitting right here, right now. We're not trying to harness it from anywhere else. We know this, right? We know this. We know this as coaches. We know this as hypnotherapists, where every answer is within. We're not harnessing it elsewhere. It is within our unconscious processes. And people, each and every person on this planet, display and express their unconscious information very differently. Even the same person at this moment in time is going to express their unconscious information differently, if we meet them a week from now. And so having this really thorough understanding is what's really truly going to help us with the transformative work, and helps set ourselves up for success, because then if we know about our own unconscious processes, then we are better equipped to help others, right? And so I just wanted to clarify this because that statement was very shocking to me. And again, very untrue. And hopefully you learned something from this. And if you have any questions at all, let me know, and I will see you soon.